Hi everyone. This session I'm going to show how a helical antenna can be designed in the normal and axial mode by theoretical formulation. Helical antenna is categorized as broadband antenna. As a circularly polarized antenna, a helical antenna is widely used in radar, navigation satellite, and mobile systems due to its simple structure, wide bandwidth, low cost, and high gain. The helical antenna can operate in many modes. However, two principal ones are the normal and the axial modes. In the normal mode of operation, the field radiated by the antenna is maximum in a plane normal to the helix axis and minimum along its axis. The pattern is similar in shape to that of a small dipole or circular loop. The term axial mode refers to the tendency of the antenna to radiate in the direction of the helix ends instead of laterally, if the helix circumference is of the order of one wavelength. Moreover, the axial mode helix also radiates a predominantly circularly polarized wave. Circular polarization is important in the space communication as well as in terrestrial mobile applications because the favorable relative orientation between linear polarized transmitting and receiving is not guaranteed. Moreover, for space applications, Faraday rotation through the ionosphere is generally unpredictable. In this slide, you can see the different parameters which are needed for the helical antenna design. At the first, the design procedure of the helical antenna in order to operate in the normal mode is explained. Typically, the diameter of ground plane for both operation modes should be at least 3/4 of the wavelength. The axial ratio parameter, which is defined as the ratio of the magnitudes of the theta and phi electric field components, is given by this equation. In addition, the circumference of helix can be obtained using an assumed value for the axial ratio. For example, with the condition of pure circular polarization, axial ratio is unity. By obtaining the circumference of helix and the axial ratio value, we can calculate the spacing between each turn versus L0 parameter and the wavelength. And for L0 parameter, an acceptable value should be considered. To achieve the normal mode of operation, the dimensions of helix are usually small compared to the wavelength, that means this condition. Using it, we can obtain the number of helix turns. The other important parameter is the pitch angle, which is shown in the previous two slides. This parameter is computed using this equation and has a value between 0 and 90 degrees. The geometry of the helix reduces to a loop of diameter d when the pitch angle approaches 0 and to a linear wire of length s when it approaches 90 degrees. In this section, the design procedure for the axial mode is presented. The same as normal mode, the ground plane diameter should be greater than 3/4 of the wavelength. To achieve circular polarization, primarily in the major lobe, the circumference of the helix must be in this range. Also, the axial ratio for the condition of increased directivity is computed based on the number of helix turns by this equation. So we can obtain the number of turns according to the considered axial ratio value. In next step, we should consider a value for the pitch angle parameter. In order to achieve the optimum design, the pitch angle should be between 12 and 14 degrees. By this condition, the space in between each turn can be calculated using this relation. After that, the remaining parameters such as total length of antenna, total length of wire, and half power beamwidths are obtained by these relations. The feed point impedance of the helical antenna is too high for the 50 ohm antenna impedance. So one challenging problem in the design of helical antenna is the impedance matching. To achieve the impedance matching, in general, three items should be satisfied: minimum S11, minimum VSWR, and pure real input impedance, which is equal to 50 ohm, should be verified in the bandwidth range. One of the simplest techniques for the impedance matching of the helical antenna is modifying the feed with a wide strip that acts as a wideband impedance transformer. This strip is attached to the first quarter of turn of the helix, and the strip width can be obtained by optimization process during full wave simulation. This strip forms a tapered transmission line transformer that provides the necessary frequency independent match between the helix and the 50 ohm source. Here you can find the design parameters of a helical antenna with the center frequency of 3 GHz, which are calculated using the presented formulation with these assumptions. Finally, my presentation for the design procedure of the helical antenna is completed. I'll be happy you like my video and subscribe to my channel to watch more contents of electromagnetic component design and simulation. If you enjoyed this video, please share it with your friends to spread the electromagnetic knowledge. If you have any questions, feel free and just put comment. Thank you for watching. Have a good time.